All right, we're back here in Newark, New Jersey, courtside at the WEC after the Highlanders get a 74-70 win, home win over Kennesaw State, joined by top assistant Jeff Rafferty for the RAF Report. Now, the life of a college basketball coach, I mean, the highs and the lows, the ups and the downs. You guys erased the loss, the tough one on Saturday, pull out this game today. I mean, the emotions have got to be running high with these tight games.
Yeah, we make it interesting. You know, we got the win tonight. That's what was important. It was not pretty. I thought we played really well in the first half. And then Kennesaw does a really good job of making the game ugly, and they did. And we got caught in that trap. And actually, early on in the game, when we built up that lead, I thought we did an excellent job of turning our stops into transition baskets or at least open offense. If we didn't score in transition, it was secondary action. We had the court spread, and we got some good looks. Once we stopped getting stops and it became a half-court game the last 7 minutes of the first half, that's when we were stagnant at both ends. And that allowed them to you know, cut the lead to 9 or 10 at the half. And then it was a similar pattern here early in the second half, and we were able to bounce back, you know, and extend the lead a little bit, you know, later to get some momentum. But, yeah, they made it ugly.
Well, look, Raph, the talking heads like, you know, me over here, we can say, well, maybe it's good because this team is trying to learn how to win, if that even is a thing. Now, look, the Highlanders had a 21-point lead. They got behind and then stormed back to grab another 10-point lead.
Right.
Is there something to the fact that, you know, they didn't say, here we go again, but instead got tough after giving up the lead?
Yeah, I mean, you can look at it both sides. You know, I'm encouraged by the fact we've been able to build some good leads within the league. The concern is we've given away some big leads, and we did so on Saturday, obviously, under some interesting circumstances. And tonight we did it again. I didn't like how we allowed them to change the whole tempo and momentum of the game tonight. That's a concern of mine. But, you know, and this is by no means an excuse, but, we do have a young team, and we're also still playing a lot of guys. And a lot of times when you have interesting rotations out there, guys that haven't been in that situation, you know, and you face different things defensively and things of that nature, things can get a little choppy, and that's what happened tonight. But we need to learn from this and continue to grow and be able to put good teams and put conference teams away when we get a big lead and you know, not squander it. It's a game of runs. It's college basketball. There's always going to be runs, but you can't be giving up 20-point leads.
Okay, I want to ask about two particular players. I want to start with Abdul Lewis. A lot of times we talk about his offense, his ability to pass, which is tremendous out of the post. But how about his defense tonight? Only one foul. It seemed to me he did a very good job walling up, maintaining his territory, and defending the paint.
Yeah, and to be honest, I'm not even sure the one was a foul. It looked like verticality to me. But he. And he didn't. He played physical tonight. You know what I mean. So it wasn't like he was disengaged defensively. I thought he was very involved. And you know, they don't have bigs that necessarily score the ball in the post, but they get him involved in a lot of ball screen situations and dribble drive. And against these guys, you know, you can't help off of Scott and you can't help off of Masterson. So on dribble drive, he was the one stepping up and he was a help defender. And I thought he did an excellent job in help. You know, per usual, and again on the glass. I mean, he ended up with 8 rebounds, but he did a really good job. You know, when they were making a run of only giving them one shot.
Finally, I want to ask you about Zach Cooks. He continues to play well. You know, it's not always start to finish an excellent masterpiece, but he's just a freshman, and boy, he's hit some really big shots down the stretch of games and may have turned this whole thing back around in favor of the Highlanders tonight.
Yeah, the corner three was a big shot. And, you know, he does some things. You know, he's had a really, really good freshman year. You know, and he's played with different combinations. He's come off. He's been a really good, solid backup point guard for us. But then we've played him and Shaquan, extended minutes together here the second half of the season. He was up and down early on in the game today. You know, Coach gave him a quick pull a couple times. But then once we went back to him and gave him extended run down the stretch tonight, you know, I think he played the better part of the last 7 or 8 minutes with and without Shaquan. But I thought he, once he hit that corner three, he had a big steal. I mean, he just, you know, he can really, he's a momentum changer, you know, defensively. And he's a fearless kid offensively who can get us in an offense, but he's also not afraid to take big shots. And tonight I thought he was excellent down the stretch.
five games, what, 10 days, and now you don't play again until Saturday in Lipscomb. So kind of rejuvenate, recharge the batteries, and right. Best of luck in Nashville.
Terrific. Thanks.
All right. That is top assistant Jeff Rafferty weighing in on tonight's 74-71 win over Kennesaw. We thank you for watching this edition of the Raff Report.